Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Till now, I have covered all the major topics related to boilers which are asked in the exams. So if you think I have missed out any topics which are asked by the surveyor, then you can comment down below my video in the comment section and I'll try to make video on that topic. And if you want to get more videos related to machines on board ship, then you can subscribe to my channel as slowly I'll cover all the machineries on board ship. Now let's come to the video which I am going to cover now. This video is on stresses in the boiler which need to be taken care during design of the boiler. So let's begin. Stresses in the boiler shell. Cylindrical shell is subjected to internal pressure. This sets up stresses in the circumferential and longitudinal axis. If the pressure acting, the stresses are set up in circumferential and longitudinal axis. The stresses which are there in the circumferential axis, that I'll tell you. If the pressure acting upon the circumference is resolved in horizontal components, the resulting horizontal force is equal to the pressure into projected area. This force is resisted by the force set up in the longitudinal joints. For equilibrium condition, horizontal force to the left is equal to horizontal force to the right. So horizontal force to the left is pressure into projected area, which is equal to resisting force in the longitudinal joint. So the force to the right, we consider that boiler is joined, the boiler shell is made by joining the shell. See, this is the joint in the longitudinal direction. So the force, these forces which are acting on the projected area, they need to be equal to the force which are acting on this longitudinal joint. So the pressure into projected area, pressure into projected area is equal to stress into cross-section area of the joint. So this cross-section area of this joint. Pressure into diameter into length, that is the pressure which is there is a force which is acting on the horizontal forces on the left side is equal to stress into twice into thickness into length. So cross-section area of this joint is length, this length into thickness, and this joint is also down below over here. So we have multiplied with 2. So stress into 2 into thickness into length, this is the force which is acting on the joints, which has to be equal to the pressure, the force which is acting on the projected area, the pressure into diameter into length. So projected area, this projected area, its area is, it is like this. So this is diameter and this is length. So area is equals to L into D. So after equating and putting the stress on one side, stress in the longitudinal joint is equal to pressure into diameter divided by 2 into thickness. So this is the circumferential stresses. Now let's go on longitudinal stresses which are developed on the, in the boiler. So for longitudinal stresses, we need to assume that the end plate is welded. This is the end plate which is welded. So the longitudinal stresses, the force acting upon the end plate is restricted, is resisted by the stress set up in the circumferential joint. So this is the circumferential joint, this one, this joint. So for equilibrium condition, horizontal force to the left is equal to horizontal force to the right. So these forces needs to be equal. So horizontal force to the left is a pressure into end plate area. So end plate area is pi d square by 4. End plate area, pi d square by 4. Pressure into pi d square by 4 is the force acting towards the left. And towards the right, we have resisting force in the circumferential joint. Resisting force in the circumferential joint is this. This is this area. This area of the thickness of the cylinder. So stress into cross section area of the joint. Stress into cross section area of the joint. So stress into pi d. Pi d is the circumference into thickness, which gives the area of the cross section. So this is the stress forces on the right hand side. So by solving this equation, we get to know stresses in the circumferential joint is equal to pressure into diameter into divided by 4 times the thickness. So this is the stress which is acting in the which is longitudinal stress. So hope this video will help you in clearing exams. My next series of video will be on purifiers, and after that on the MARPOL equipments on board ship. So if you want, you can subscribe to my channel and keep learning. So thank you, friends. Have a good day.